Kahoa, welcome to the Marquesas, the easternmost archipelago of French Polynesia. After 7 months here, I can compile the best spots to visit from towns, museums and mountains, or activities to do such as surfing, snorkeling, sailing, and base to anchor safely with breathtaking views. Please drop your like and comment and subscribe to this channel. There are really, really more videos to come. Welcome aboard Winderlust. My name is João and I've been traveling in this planet since 15 years ago. And now I'm traveling on my Beneteau Cyclades since 2020. From Spain to Cape Verde to the Caribbean, Panama, and now finally French Polynesia. This episode, I want to guide you through the best travel tips and cruising guides in this fantastic, really fantastic archipelago of French Polynesia, Marquesas. Marquesas, Fenua, Enata, Enua, Henana, Marquise. The cruising period here is all year round, but it's calmer in September to April in what regards to crowds, to rain, but it's safe year round. For traveling onwards, the best time to go for the Tuamotus is from May to September. Please support this channel at patreon.com/winderlust. There you get exclusive content in advance and you help to keep this channel updated. I really appreciate. French Polynesia, Marquesas Islands, Travel Tips and Cruising Guide, Episode 21. Marquesas, Fenua, Enata is an archipelago of French Polynesia filled with mysticism. Being the main first port of call when sailing from the east, these islands surprise you by their welcoming spirit, friendliness and scenic dramatic landscapes, being at the same time in an undoubtful tropical paradise. I've spent 7 months in it and have compiled these travel tips and cruising guides which, filled with humility, I am proud to share. Hope you enjoy this land of man, the meaning for Fenua Enata in Marquesian language, as much as I did. And utmost welcome to Polynesia. Kahoa iaorana. Nuku'iwa is the first port of call in Polynesia to many yachts. It has incredible landscapes, trails, waterfalls and base to anchor. Taihoe is the main anchorage. It has loads of room but still always keep a free radius of 30 meter minimum around your anchor. Stern anchor is not mandatory on this bay, but be sure to check that your anchoring neighbors do not have one. For groceries, head to Larsen, just on the main street. For vegetables, get them next to the dinghy quay. The nautical store next to the ATM on the main street is well stocked and it's worth a visit. Just in the main town of Atuana there is great surfing for all levels. It's best from September to January and from March to August maybe you should head to the north coast, Anayapa. In Ivaoa, Atuana, visit the Paul Gauguin and Jacques Brel Museum. I also advise you to go check Mango Bar, either in the mornings or evenings, there is great food and live music. In Hanayapa, in the north coast, where you can do great surfing and anchor your boat. That's where one of the Pogogan's descendants still lives nowadays. Also be sure to visit Tahuata, the island just next to Ivahoa, where you have Anamuenua, Hapatoni. These are all great spots to visit. Anayapa is an incredible bay. You can surf on a right-hander mellow wave, which can get big in certain periods of the year, when Northwell is on. A great grandson of Pogogan lives here. And not just for the bay or the surf, it deserves a visit. You can also anchor on it, and it's a really scenic place to anchor on. If you look for an organized tour in Ivaoa, contact Ivaoa Aventure. Please drop your like and comment and subscribe to this channel. There are really more videos to come. Atuana is a narrow anchorage. Respect the way for the ships and be mindful that boats swing due to the catabatic winds from the mountains. The shipyard and nautical store are a big plus in this anchorage, as also the victualling. And the surf and diving just next in the main town's bay are also great. Avoid swimming on anchorage as it has sewage discharges, mostly when it rains. For drinkable water, look for the public water tap in the town center. Aranui and Taporol bring supplies to all the islands of Marquesas. They are really important for the life in these islands. If you are cruising, always make free way for them to access the keys. Freshwater supply in the Marquesas can be a bit daunting, but you just have to know where to find it. In Tahoe Bay, forget it. Even for showering, I do not advise. Go instead to Houyi Bay next to Controllers Bay, where you have freshwater taps in the beach. Also beware that the Marquesas Islands face certain periods of drought when it does not rain for longer periods. Refrain to excessively use the resources by those times. Huapo is really a special treat. There is a special feeling about it. Top landscape, less crowded, more welcoming, incredible arts and crafts, and an awesome island life. For groceries, head to Mariel, just a bit uptown, or check its second shop next to the bridge to west. For crafts, visit the town hall, where you can get filtered water as well to refill. Watch football matches at the main pitch, or visit the church and arts presentations. And if you like to surf or bodyboard, check the beginner and advanced left wave on the west side of the bay. Locals are really great people. Support this channel at patreon.com/winderlust. There you get exclusive content in advance and you help to keep this channel updated. Please drop your like and comment and subscribe to this channel. There are really more videos to come. The anchorage in Hakahau is narrow. You must use stern anchor. To west, there is more swell, and also allow space for the cargos Aranui and Taporo pass, as all the island depends on them. The seawater is really beautiful and safe to dive. Snorkeling is prolific as fishing. For fishing, the west part of the bay is more prolific, either with the rod or harpoon. Locals here are just incredible people. You have to experience this island life. Be sure to do it.
C'est beaucoup, hein? Content, lui.
Allez, bana!
Bana! Oh, merci beaucoup, hein? Content, lui, hein? Merci, hein? Merci beaucoup. Vous allez pêcher?
Oui.
Bon courage!
The most beautiful scene tikis I've seen in the Marquesas are definitely in Oahu. Always remember to use stern anchor on this Hakahau anchorage. There you can also get to see vahas, people rowing around. It's like their local sport. I was also fortunate enough to be in the island when there was a school presentation, Tapa Tapa. Please drop your like and comment and subscribe to this channel. There are really, really more videos to come. And by the end of the day, almost every day, I would go surf or doing bodyboards with the locals. Here you can see Te Ahui Aka Guillaume. As for safety, Marquesas are probably one of the safest destinations in the whole world. As a solo sailor, in group, as a male, a female, it does not matter. It is really safe. People here are very, very welcoming and friendly. As for money, all main towns have one or two ATMs, either the postal service, post, or the private bank called Socredo.
Hey, good morning everyone. So today I got a mission ahead. Just gonna start now and let me just explain you why. So basically yesterday I was surfing and one of the keels here got lost in the ocean. Can you believe that? I was surfing in a wave just close by the anchorage here in Wapo. Let me just show you how beautiful this is. Once again. And there's a mellow, nice wave just behind the catamaran and a monohull just behind it. And yeah, the keel just got there because I was kind of hit by a stronger wave, and with all the turmoil, you know, it's like the washing machine, as we say it sometimes, and the keel just touched my hand, and luckily enough I just unscrewed the screws that, you know, keep it in its position, so the keel just left. Otherwise I think maybe I would cut severely my hand, so it's all good for that. But obviously I want to look for it, the keel. So I'm gonna do some free diving here. I got already the kit. You know, got some nice fins here. Yeah. And that's it. So wish me some luck. And I'm gonna do some footage of the seabed here. It's quite beautiful. It's kind of reef. It's not reef. It's a mix of reef and river rocks, you know, like boulders. Yeah, so wish me luck. All right.
Please drop your like and comment and subscribe to this channel. There are really, really more videos to come.
Not one day later when the baby could speak. He tore apart his nest with a quick technique. Struck by the strength of his own sharp beak. Bound to the sound of his mother's shriek.
Yeah, what's up, what's up? So I totally found
the fin. Look at it. Huh? Three. Man, so lucky. I don't know, it was just like a fluke. I was just about to leave. And
suddenly some other surfer bumped into the water.
And obviously I was on the reef break. And I don't know, I just saw it there. Ah, great. I just had to catch it.
Sorry guys, I couldn't film it, you know, I was just so excited I found it.
And then just swam back to the yacht. And now I'm gonna paddle back to the spot and join a surfer that is there already too. And it's gonna have fun.
Have a good day.
Just a big, big, big shout out to the local surfers. Tive, Teahuia, Anunua, Aruna. The fisherman, thanks for the fish. All the others. It's a really, really great community. Support this channel at patreon.com/winderlust. There you get exclusive content in advance and you help to keep this channel updated. And I'm not closing down this video before talking about the two other Marquesas islands, which are Fatuhiva and Wahuka. As for Fatuhiva, you can reach it by taxi boat departing Ivahoa or by sail yacht. There is great surfing there, and there is a breathtaking anchorage in Anavave. The shortest pass to the Tuamotus starts there in Fatuhiva or at Tuapu, depending if you go south or north in the Tuamotus. For Wahuka, it's a really more off the beaten track island, but there is great surfing there, and it's also a great starting point if you're sailing from north to the south in the Marquesas.